Let's talk about all the different parts of a chemical reaction that you will have to be able to identify within a word problem in order to be able to get to a balanced equation. We're not going to balance equations in this particular video, but we are going to look at how to at least transcribe the information from words to a chemical equation with all the parts represented. And then we're going to do a brief classification of chemical reactions as far as how to identify what type of a chemical reaction that we have. So we need basically five things from a chemical reaction. We need the reactants, we need the products, we need to then be able to, from words, pull the states of matter, okay? And then from our knowledge of naming, we are able to get the subscripts for each of our reactants and products, and then we are able to balance the equation to get the coefficients. Okay, so we need all of those things. So let's look at what they look like given this example of a combustion reaction that we have here. So steam is formed when methane gas is burned in air along with carbon dioxide gas. So reactants, what are we doing? We're burning methane gas in air. So methane, we learned from our hydrocarbon naming rules, is CH4, okay, one carbon, then 2N plus 2 hydrogens is 2 times 1 plus 2 is 4, so methane gas. So we get the reactant methane and the other reactant in air. That doesn't directly tell us, but our knowledge of combustion reaction knows that combustion occurs when oxygen is a reactant. What does this do? This yields steam. We know that steam is a state of water, and then carbon dioxide gas. Okay, and so we've got our reactants and products down. So now we have to know what the subscripts are and the states of matter. So we know methane, we've already got that. We know that we have a diatomic molecule, oxygen, that we've learned from our list of diatomic molecules. Water we know is H2O. Carbon dioxide we know from the prefixes on the molecular compound name. Okay, so the subscript is lower, or is a number that is in subscript relative to the rest of the letters and numbers, and so it represents numbers of atoms. Okay, so this is numbers of atoms for a subscript within a molecule. Coefficients are going to be numbers of molecules or ionic compounds. So it's going to be a number of the whole thing rather than what comprises a single one of the molecules. So then we have to balance. Okay, and so we'll talk about doing that in detail later. Okay, but for now, we need to get an even number of oxygens, and so there we have 2 times 4 hydrogens, we're good, and so then we need 4 oxygens, okay, 1 carbon to 1 carbon, so we're good. So the coefficient then, if we have a coefficient, coefficients are in the same line as the letters, okay, so they're uppercase numbers here, so to speak. They're not subjugated relative to the rest of the line, and they represent the balancing of the equation, the numbers of molecules present. So there are 2 water molecules present, for example. There are 2 oxygen molecules present, and there are 1 molecule of both methane and CO2 present. So all the parts here. Now we have to pull states of matter from the information. Okay, and steam, we know, is gaseous water. Methane gas, it tells us methane is a gas, natural gas, is burned in air along with carbon dioxide gas. So we get all of these directly, steam indirectly, okay? And then oxygen, we know, is a diatomic gas because we've learned that from our elements chapter, okay? So we've got all the parts necessary for the chemical equation at this point. All right, so we've got to pull all that information. Everything's got to have a phase. 4 reactants, 4 phases. four coefficients. One is not necessary to write, only if it's more than one. Subscripts, if necessary. Okay, so carbon monoxide would not have a subscript because ones are not necessary to put. Anything more than one we have to put as a subscript, and then reactants and products are all derived from the word problem. Okay, so you need to get a lot of practice with that and from the homework, and if you have any trouble, we can work some of these out together. So once we've got a chemical equation, we need to be able to classify these in a few different categories. And so synthesis reactions, also known as an addition, also known as a combination, depending on which textbook you're using. So generically, if we have two different products, we could have 3A plus B plus C. Ideally, we would have many things or more than one synthesize or combine into one thing. So we go from many parts to a whole in a synthesis reaction. Decomposition goes the other way. So we're just looking at how to recognize these and categorize these given a reaction. So a decomposition would be the opposite. It would go from a single or few to more pieces than we started with. A single replacement reaction, we'll see more on these later when we talk about the activity series. Okay, usually will involve a generic format of a single thing and then some compound that is aqueous is in solution, and then we will replace one of those as either a solid or a gas. Okay, so this will be either a solid or a gas. This will either be a solid or a gas, and we will replace which one goes in the compound, in the aqueous compound. And so then A then goes into solution, and we get B coming out as a precipitate or as a gas. Okay, so precipitation just means a solid is formed, and then gas evolution, a gas would bubble off. So we replace a single thing. And a double replacement, also called a displacement, also called a metathesis reaction, so either one of those will work. We could have an acid-base reaction. So like we saw previously in the acid-base video, we could say HCl plus NaOH, and again, I'm being bad and ignoring phases here, but everything is aqueous except for the formation of water. Okay, just speeding up here a little bit. So acid base will form water, but we will replace two different things. So the way it looks, we have AB generically plus CD. We're just going to double replace the partners. So we just exchange dance partners. Okay, that's all a double replacement does. And so one example would be an acid base reaction. Another example might be a precipitation reaction where a solid is formed. For example, we could have sodium chloride and silver nitrate, all aqueous, silver 1 nitrate, exchange partners to form a solid, silver chloride, plus sodium nitrate. So anything not marked as liquid or solid here is aqueous. Just to save time, we're already balanced. And so we form that solid. That's a precipitation reaction. More on that in a different video, okay, with the solubility rules. Okay, and then a redox reaction, we're going to have a change in oxidation number. And so any one of the above besides the double replacement reactions can have a change in oxidation number. And so we have to note that more than one of these categories can describe a single reaction. Okay, so be careful about that. We can have more than one category represented by a single reaction, but change in oxidation number, and again, more on that in a different video as well. Combustion is going to be a combustion of an alkane, for example, like we had above, the reaction above is going to react with oxygen. Reacts with oxygen to form, when it's an alkane, to form carbon dioxide and water. That's complete combustion. Incomplete combustion would form carbon monoxide, but we will focus more on complete combustion.